Amen. Bwana sifiwe sana popote ambapo unatushika katika mtandao huu wa God is Able. Nataka kukaribisha na najua ni Jumapili ambao Bwana ameweza kuitengeneza. Ninaomba ya kwamba rehema za Bwana na fadhili za Bwana zikuwe pamoja na wewe asubuhi ya leo. May the Lord fulfill your dreams, your desire. May the Lord fight your battles, whatever you desired this day to see and to have. May the Lord grant unto you. I know each and every one of us has a desire. We have walked early in the morning having desires, having expectation, and things that we have prayed that God may fulfill in our life. I know you have those things, and I come to encourage you. And it's my prayer that the Lord of heaven may fulfill those desires. May God push you to great heights. May the Lord continue to fight your battles. May you receive healing. Those who are watching us and they're in the bed, and they are feeling somehow as if they are distressed, they are discouraged, they are not able to do what they wanted to do this day, I'm here to pray for you and to tell God to heal you and God to touch your life and the Lord to push you to great heights in your life. May you live to see your children's children. I declare you're not going to die in that bed. God is going to make you. God is going to heal you. God is going to raise you from your sick bed. God will cause you to be victorious in all challenges that you are facing in life. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord be with you and may the Lord push you to great heights. Karibu sana. And the joy of the Lord be upon you. I believe this is a great day, and the Lord is going to visit you, and the Lord is going to touch you and to bless you and to heal you. Karibu sana, Bwana wabariki sana. Today I want to speak how we can recover ourselves from challenges that we face or from a crisis. How you recover yourself from a crisis. Each and every one of us, we are vulnerable. We can be attacked. We can face a crisis in life. We can face a challenge in our life where we feel that we have no ability to be able to cope or to be able to cope with that challenge that has appeared or emerged in our life. But I want to say that God of heaven can help us, and the Lord can give you strength to be able to go to walk through that challenge, and you may come out victoriously. And today we are going to measure with two people in the Bible. We're going to see the children of Israel when they were in a crisis, and also look David, the king of Israel, when he was also in a crisis, how he was able to come out of that crisis, and how the Israelites, in one way, they were not able to recover from the crisis they had faced in life. Na mimi najua kwamba Mungu anaweza kukusaidia, and you can come out of that crisis that you are today safely and victoriously without it destroying you, because a crisis can push you to great heights, and also a crisis can destroy you. A crisis can reveal can uncover you, that people can see you, your dream, your vision, your destiny, your ministry. It can be known through a crisis ambao umekutana nao kwa maisha. The same way that crisis can also sink your dream, can also destroy you. So it all depends how you are going to do in a crisis. Utatufanya nini? What are you going to do? Are you going to stay there and die there? Are you going to throw your hands? Are you going to resign to the fate? Or you are going to rise up and fight for yourself? My prayer and my counsel to you, wherever you are, is that rise up from that crisis and start to wage a spiritual warfare. And I know God will be with you. Mungu atakuwa pamoja nawe. Listen what David says, that even when I walk in the shadow of death, I will not fear, because one thing that I know, that your comfort, that your goodness and mercies will go together with me. David says, even if I pass a crisis that can destroy me, I will not fear any evil, for I'm confident of this, that your Lord and your staff will comfort me. Kwa hivyo, tunaona ya kwamba, how David was able to overcome the crisis na to come out victoriously in all crises he entered, because he trusted God. Kwa hivyo, karibu sana, and may the Lord be with you. And I want to read the word of God as I speak of five things that can help you to recover yourself from a crisis. Number one, I want us to see in the book of 1 Samuel, reading from chapter 30 and verse 1. David and his men reached Ziklag on that day, and now the Amalekites had raided Negev and Ziglag, and they had attacked Ziglag and burned it, and had taken captive women and all who were in it, both young and old. They killed none of them, but they carried them off as they went on their way. When David and his men came to Ziglag, they found it destroyed by fire, and their wives and their sons and daughter were taken captive. So David and his men wept loudly until they had no strength and left to weep. And David's two wives had been captured, Ahino of Jezreel and Abigail, the widow of Nabal of Carmel. And David was greatly distressed because the men who were talking of stoning him, each one was bitter in his spirit because of their sons and daughter. But David found strength in the Lord his God. Praise the name of the Lord. Here we can see that David has entered in a crisis. And the town has been burned. Ziglag has been burned down. The wives and the children and those people who are left in Ziglag, together with all their property, have been taken captive. And the Amalekites had gone with them. And when David came and found that Ziglag has been burned down, his children, his wife, and the people were taken captive by the Amalekites, the Bible says they wept, all of them, together with the people. And David was so distressed because the men that had gone to war with David were talking how to stone him because of their frustration, their discouragement. They were caught up in a crisis where they were not able to recover themselves, and they decided, because of the bitterness of their soul for what has happened in Ziglag, that they may stone David. You see, brethren, sometimes when a crisis comes, we can make wrong decision. And we can see that these people were about to make a wrong decision that could cost them heavily. They could have lost completely their wives, their children, and everything that the enemy had taken if they had stoned David to death. But I thank God, because God intervened in that matter when David encouraged himself in the Lord. And it's my prayer for each and every one of us that when we find ourselves in a crisis, before we react, before we do anything, before we make any decision, sometimes it's good to win ourselves. Never enter into crisis without winning yourself first. Because if you're not able to win yourself, you cannot be able to win other people. And this is a place where many people fail, because they react out of emotion in a crisis, and they end up doing the wrong thing or making the wrong decision, and they fail to recover what the enemy had taken from their life. But I thank God for David, and we can learn from him. And we are going to learn about five things that can help us to recover in a crisis. Let's now look at the people. Let's look at the Israelites. So we compare them with David. And we can read in the book of Psalms 137, and I'm reading from verse 1. By the rivers of Babylon, we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. There on the purpose we hung our harps, for our captors spoke of us, asked us for a song. Our tormentor demanded a song of joy, and they said, sing us one of the songs of Zion. How can we sing the song of the Lord where in a foreign land? These are the children of Israel. They had been taken captive. And I know this is the time of Zedekiah, when the children of Israel were taken captive and taken to Babylon. This was a very heavy crisis, because Jerusalem was burned down. The walls of Jerusalem was burned down. The temple was burned down. And the children of Israel were taken captive to Babylon. The Bible says when they reached there, they sat down on the rivers of Babylon, and they started to weep when they remembered the good things, and they remembered how their city was destroyed, and how they used to come and gather in that city, and God appeared to them, and God fought their battles. So because of that stress and that sadness in their heart and that bitterness of their heart, they sat down and wept bitterly without doing anything. And then the captors, those who took them captive, started to mock them and started to tell them, sing us one song, the song of joy which you used to sing in Zion. And they said, how can we sing a Lord's song in a foreign land? But the point I want to make here is that the children of Israel, when they reached there, And in that crisis, they hung their weapons of worship. And they forgot that God has ordained worship in the hearts of the lip, in the mouth of the suckling and the babies because of the enemy. That's what the Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 8 and verse 2. So they could not pick the weapon of worship and praise to start to fight their enemies because they were full of bitterness and pain in their heart. And because of that, they made a wrong decision. And from this point, these people are to stay over 70 years in Babylon because they were not ready to fight or to recover themselves. They were not able to recover themselves. Actually, it is their children who came. People like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and Daniel, that were able to rise up, and they fought, and they prayed, and they fasted, that the children of Israel were to be taken back to Jerusalem. I want to say that sometimes many people in a crisis, they make wrong decision and they fail to recover themselves. You can fail completely to recover yourself in a crisis if you don't rise up and face that crisis. Let me speak of five things that can help us, or learning from David, how we can be able to come out of a crisis that comes in our life. One of the ways that you can be able to recover from a crisis is to have self-discipline. Each and every person who is able to make in a crisis must be somebody who is disciplined in life. And we can see the discipline of David in this place. When people started to say they are going to kill him, they are going to stone him, David was able to comfort himself with the Lord his God. He was disciplined. He knew the rules of the war and how he can be able to come out. He didn't argue with these people. He was so much disciplined. Though he was the leader, he didn't rise up and start to defend himself or to fight back, saying, I'm your leader. You're going to do what I say. But we can see the discipline in the life of this man, that he knew this is not the time to react. This is not the time to argue. This is not the time to fight. He knew it was a time to seek the will of God and to seek the face of God, that God may be able to help him to come out of that crisis. And the Bible shows us clearly, when David decided to seek the will of God and the face of God, God revealed himself and God gave him a strategy, and he was able to rise up. And David was able to recover everything that the enemy had taken from him, and was able to destroy the enemies and took back the children and the property and the wife. You can also recover yourself from a crisis. Maybe you're in a marriage crisis. Your marriage has broken down and you feel that you have come to the end yourself and there is nothing else you can be able to do. I want to tell you, you can come out of that crisis and you can be able to recover. You can be able to recover. When you recover yourself, you can be able to recover others. Remember what Jesus told Peter, that when you have already recovered yourself, you'll be able to recover your brothers. That shows us that if you're not able to recover yourself from a crisis, you cannot be able to recover your children, you cannot be able to recover your marriage, you cannot be able to recover your career or your ministry. So may God help us that we may be disciplined when we're in a crisis, not to be in a hurry of making wrong decision that can cause us so much in our life or can cause us to lose completely whatever that has been taken away from us. You look somebody like Samson, was not disciplined. He didn't have discipline of himself. When I mean to discipline yourself is to put boundaries in your life. That even if I'm in a crisis, there are things I cannot do. There are boundaries I cannot cross. Because that's how you discipline yourself. Because in a crisis, you can become so angry that you cross certain borders in your life, and that causes you to make a wrong decision and costs you everything in your life. Samson was not able to discipline himself according to the word of God. You have the word of God. The word of God is a map. The word of God is our measuring load. So as much you are hurted, as much you are in pain, remember there is the word of God. And don't go beyond the borders of the word of God. discipline yourself and you'll be able to win everything. Eh? The Bible says you can get angry, but don't remain angry until evening. Eh? So you can be able to recover yourself by having discipline. Know what to do at that time. Know what not to do. Discipline yourself that even though I'm hurting, I cannot go beyond these measures. The Israelites were not able to discipline themselves. They knew very well that they are supposed to worship their God, whether in a crisis, whether in joy, whether in printer, whether in victory. They were there to praise and to worship God. But this time, because of what has happened with them, they decided this time we are not going to worship God. And they failed. And that's why the enemy was to have an upper hand over them, because they are not ready to fight and to confront that issue by praise. Praise could have given them victory. They never knew that these enemies were telling them to load their guns. Eh? And if they could have entered in praise at that time, they could have been able to come out of Babylon very easily, because God could have intervened. Look, Jehoshaphat, when he was in a crisis, he was so disciplined that he went to seek and to inquire from the Lord what he's supposed to do at that situation. And the Lord told him, Jehoshaphat, put the singers in front, for the battle does not belong to you. When you engage yourself in praise and worship, you are inviting God to take over the battles. And that's what exactly that Jehoshaphat did. And he was able to invite God in his battle, and God took over, and God was able to conquer for them. And I know, even today, despite of what has happened in your life, you can be able to praise God, you can be able to invite him. Eh? You can invite him, and God can take over. Another thing that we are supposed to do in a crisis, we are supposed to have self-control. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs 25 and verse 28, he that has no rule over his own heart is like a city whose walls have been broken down. If you cannot rule your own heart, the Bible says it's just like a city that walls are broken down. It has no defense. Eh? Self-control is very important in crisis. In crisis, you must have self-control. And we can learn and we can see it from the life of David. You can imagine at that time when people were discussing that they are going to stone him to death. And you know this, David also is a victim like them. David has lost his wife. David has lost his wives, his children, and everything. And because he was a king, actually he's the one who has suffered more than all other guys. Maybe some of them didn't have wives, they didn't have properties, but they were all crying that they were until when there was no strength left in them. And the decision they were trying to make was a very wrong decision, to stone David. Yet the enemy was still pursuing, was still moving away with what he had taken. By stoning David, they could not be able to recover. But David had control of himself. And I say, in this crisis that you are having today, whatever has happened to your life, whether it's a marriage that has broken, please rise up and have self-control. Don't destroy yourself because of what has happened. Because destroying yourself will not be able to recover what already the enemy has taken. But if you can be able to recover yourself from that crisis and rise up, and be joyful and know that life has to continue despite of what has taken place. Life has to continue. I've seen people losing their husband, losing their children, and they don't recover from that. They become sick from that point, and eventually they die. And they spend a lot of money simply because they could not be able to recover themselves from whatever happened in their life. Yet there is a life to live. There is tomorrow. There is tomorrow. Yet you are the person that, because the husband or the wife has gone down or he has died, you are the person now remaining. You need to take control of yourself so that you can be able to save the life of the children and push them to their destiny. Now, we see if David could have not controlled himself when these people were deciding to stone him, he could have lost his mind. He could have not gone. He could have not remembered how to inquire from God. He could have become angry and start to fight and to exchange words, bitter words with these people. And that could cost him a lot. But we see in this point, David was took self-control of himself and he was able to navigate himself in that crisis and that shouting and the commotion that was there, and was able to go to be silenced before God, to go before God, and he offered a sacrifice. I don't know if I was the one, how could I have behaved in such a situation? Could I really be able to go before God? If you don't have self-control, if you can't control your anger, if you cannot control your pain, if you cannot control your emotions, you cannot be able to have a time to go to before the Lord and inquire. Eh? You cannot be able to worship God. You cannot be able to praise God. There are people even today who don't worship God or praise God, or they don't love God because of something that happened in their life. And we can go back to the book of Numbers chapter 14 and see the children of Israel. Simply because the people brought a bad report and told them that they cannot have the land. And in that land there are giants, and the people are so great that they have chariots, so they cannot be able to fight them. We can see when people had that report, they were not able to recover themselves back. The Bible says they were taken by emotion, by murmuring, by crying, and all those things, until they came to a place where they lost themselves completely, and they decided, now we are going to go back to Egypt and choose another leader to take us to Egypt. That was a wrong decision. That was a wrong decision. They could not control themselves. They were so bitter. They were so angry with God and Moses that they decided, now they have done away with Moses and God, and they picked themselves another leader to take them to the promised land. Brethren, even if you are in pain, control yourself. Control yourself. Don't go beyond some boundaries in your life. Have discipline. Have self-control over your life. Decide there are things, it doesn't matter what has happened, you cannot do in your life. That's what self-control. Control yourself. Control your emotion. Control your anger. Control your pain. Control even your joy. There are also people sometimes, they go overboard when they are happy, and they get themselves sinning against God because of the joy or because of the victory that God has given themselves. In whichever state or situation you are in, control yourself. Self-control is very important in your life. Look, Samson. Samson was not able to control himself. He loved Delilah with all his heart, but he could have controlled his love and that emotion, whether it was love or rush, whatever it was, but he could have controlled that situation and he could have won that battle and regained himself. But we see he lost himself, and he lost the vision and even the plan that God had with his life. And Samson died together with the Philistine. That was not the plan of God over the life of Samson, but he was not able to control himself. As we continue to wind up, let me speak of another thing that is very important. That thing is maintain control of yourself when things go wrong. There are people who cannot be able to control themselves when things go wrong in their life. Because in this world we are living, things can go wrong in our life. But can we be able to control ourselves? David is a leader. David has walked with God. Now he finds himself in a situation where things have gone wrong. He had a good plan to go and fight for the children of Israel, to go and fight the enemies of the Israelites. But things went wrong, but I thank God for him. He was able to control himself and brought things back in control. He was able to control this army because he controlled himself. When you control yourself, when things goes on, you'll be able to control other people. Let's look at Saul. Saul, when he went to a battle and something went wrong, at that time we see when Saul was in a battle, he was not able to control himself. When God could not speak, there come at times in life where God becomes silence, where God is silent, or where God is not seen, when we don't hear the voice of God, when it seems that as God has walked out of our life. He does not walk out of our life. It's we that walk out of the presence of God. But sometimes in such situation, we feel as if God has walked out of our life. If we don't control ourselves in such a moment, when we feel that God is not answering, it comes in a time. You try to pray, you try to fast, you try to sacrifice, and it's as if God is not hearing, God is not answering, God is not seeing what you're doing. In a such a situation, you need to take control of yourself. Take control of yourself. Don't allow the emotions to carry you off. Don't allow the situation to swallow you. You can be swallowed by that situation, but you can maintain control of yourself even when things have gone wrong in our life, in your life. And we can see also the disciples when they were in the ship, and Jesus was also in the ship. And in this situation, they felt as if Jesus does not care upon their life. And when the sea was rough, and the boat was being tossed from one side to another, and the disciples thought they are going to be drowned, they started to cry and to shout. They could not control themselves. Until Jesus asked them, "Where is your faith?" And he rebuked the sea, and it was calm. But you see, the disciples could not be able to control themselves. They could not do what the Lord Jesus had taught them how to fight, because of the fear that was in their life, or the danger they were facing at that moment. We also face that kind of a danger, or those moments comes in our life, but we can take control of ourselves when things even goes wrong. Saul, when things went wrong in this battle, he was not able to control himself. The Bible says he went to a witch to inquire from a witch, because God was not answering, and that broke his relationship with God, and God didn't want to hear anything about Saul, because the Bible had forbidden that they were not going to inquire from the witches. So Saul decided to go there because he couldn't control himself. May God help us, and to know that sometimes in life things can go wrong, but we can still recover. We can still rise up and fight the battle and be able to recover as David. David was able to control himself when things went wrong. Number four, you be calm in a crisis. In any crisis that come in your life, be calm in that crisis. And I would like to read a word from Matthew 27 that can give us some spiritual insight. Be calm even when a crisis comes in your life. It doesn't matter how serious it seems. Learn to be calm in crisis. Many people are not able to be calm when a crisis comes in their life. Because if you are not calm in a crisis, you will end up shouting, you end up destroying things. Instead of rectifying things, you can end up by destroying and making the matters more worse by shouting or by decisions that you make in that crisis. The Bible says in the book of Matthew 27, I'm reading from verse 24, when Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere, but instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hand in front of the crowd. "I'm innocent of this man's blood," he said. "It is your responsibility." And all the people answered, "Let his blood be on us and our children." Now I want us to see a crisis here. These are the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and they were all shouting. There was a commotion in the city, and everybody was shouting that, "Crucify this man. This is Jesus." And the whole crowd was caught up in this commotion. Others joined the choir without even knowing what they are saying. And there was a crisis. And in this crisis, we can see Pilate, when he saw that he could not be able to control the mass because of the commotion that was there, he became calm in that crisis, and he asked for a basin and water, and he washed himself, he washed his hands, and told the people, "I'm clean from the blood of this man," and was able to save himself. And the people shouted. They could not control themselves. They could not have a good reasoning. They said, "Let the blood of this man be upon us and all our children and our great grandchildren. And from that moment, these people never knew that the temple is going to be destroyed. The nation of Israel is going to be destroyed and not become a nation again. And Jesus had looked the moment when he looked Jerusalem and he wept and said, "Oh Jerusalem, I wish you could have known the season of your visitation. But since you didn't know the season, there is no stone that is going to remain in this temple. It is going to be brought down." And actually, when the temple was destroyed, later on the temple was destroyed, and the children of Israel were scattered until 1940, I think it's the Second World War, when the children of Israel were restored as a nation. For 2,000 years, they were going to stay a nation being scattered without a nation because of the words they spoke in this crisis where they could not be able to control themselves. Those crises comes in our life, but we can control ourselves. You can remain calm in a crisis. When you face a crisis in your life, before you outburst, before you take a decision, be calm. Listen from inside of yourself. Listen from inside of yourself. You can hear a voice speaking inside of you. Look outside and see what are the opportunity, what are the signs, what can I do? Rather than jump up and be quick to outburst and make a decision that can cost you a lot in your life. I thank God when people become calm in a crisis. When these people were crying, and the Bible says, until they fainted of a cry, and there was no fear left inside of them. I thank God because there was somebody who was calm in that crisis, and his name is David. He was able to be calm in that crisis, and he was able to inquire from the Lord because he had a sober mind and was able to know, I can go to God. I can ask God to help me out of this situation. People like Jehoshaphat, when they were surrounded, they were in a serious crisis where the nation of Israel was about to be wiped out. When the nation gathered, so many nations gathered, and they were about to destroy the nation of Israel. But he was so calm in that crisis, and he sought the face of God. Look at Elijah when they were surrounded. Elisha, when they were surrounded by the enemies, he was calm in that crisis. When Gehazi was crying and saying, "Master, Master, we are surrounded. We are going to perish. But we see Elisha was so calm, and he told God, "Open the eyes of Gehazi that he can be able to see that those who are on our side are more than those who are against us." Let me say this, that in every situation, even in a place where you feel as if God has forsaken you, there are angels that are surrounding our life. Even in that situation you are now, they're about to inject you out of your house. They're about to sack you from your job. They're about to take up your position, your business premises. The family is about to kick you out and take everything. They say you don't belong to them. In those situations, each and every one of us can be. I want to say you can be calm in that situation, and you can hear the voice of God speaking. Samuel was in a crisis. He didn't know where God, he didn't know what to do. And when he took the jar of oil and to anoint the brother of David, Eliab, but he had a voice from inside of him. And the voice was saying, "I've rejected him. Don't anoint him. I've rejected him. For I don't look outside like men, but I look inside." So someone had the voice inside of him. You can hear a voice, that inner voice speaking to you in that crisis. It can also give you a direction. It can also remove you from that dilemma that you are. Look, Joshua, when Joshua was in crisis, he came and saw the walls of Jericho, and he saw that he doesn't have anything to bring those walls down. He didn't have that ability to bring the walls of Jericho down. But Joshua heard from inside, and that time the angel of the Lord came, appeared to him. And Joshua asked him, because he was calm, Are you on our side or are you on the enemy side? And the angel of the Lord told Joshua, neither. I'm not in your side, neither in your enemy's side. But I'm the captain of the Lord's army. I've come to bring you a solution. And in that moment where Joshua didn't know what to do, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to him, or the angel of the Lord spoke to him, and Joshua was able to bring down the walls of Jericho because he heard a voice and he followed what God spoke to him. I say, you can come out of that situation if you can remain calm in that situation. You can be able to come out. Joshua and Caleb are a very good example. When the whole multitude was in uproar and they were shouting this and this, and when they were saying they are going to elect another leader and take them back to Egypt, they were calm and they comforted the people and told the people, even though they are giants, even though they are walls, even though they have chariot, we can be able to destroy them, and God has given us on our hands. There are mountains in life. We look at the mountains, we forgot that we have the God of mountain, God who is able to level those mountains. So be calm in that situation. Don't react. Just have a time to intercede, have a time to pray, and the Lord will bless you. And the last, be resilient in adversity. Be resilient in adversity. It doesn't matter. Can we read the word, the last word in the book of Mark, Mark 5? Be resilient. Be able to come back when you are thrown down. You can be thrown down. The Bible says a righteous man can fall 7 times, but he can rise up again. You can still rise up again. That is not end of you. The fact that you have been thrown down by a crisis does not mean that you cannot rise up from that crisis and become victoriously. I've seen people in boxing. They are very calm. They are very resilient. That when they are knocked down, they can be knocked down 3 times, but eventually they are able to rise up and come and gather themselves and be able to win the battle. We have seen it. It can also happen in your life. And as I finish, let me read Mark 5 and 24. The Bible says, so Jesus went with him, and a large crowd followed and pressed around him, and a woman was there who had been subject to the bleeding for 12 years, and she had suffered a great deal under the care of many doctors and spent all that she had. Instead of getting better, she grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak, because she thought, if just I touch the cloth, I'll be healed. And immediately her bleeding stopped, and she felt in her body that she was freed from her suffering. This is a bleeding woman. The bleeding woman had passed a very terrible crisis in her life. She was bleeding. The Bible says she spent everything she had with a physician, and her situation was not getting better, but it continued to grow worse day by day. But one day she heard of Jesus and saw that Jesus was coming. She was able to gather herself. She didn't allow the situation to destroy her. She rose up and gathered herself, and she crewed down because she could not be able to reach Jesus. And she crewed down, and the Bible says, and she spoke to herself, if only I can be able to touch the hem of his garment, then I'll be well. And she was able to do that, and she crewed down and touched the hem of the garment, and she was healed. She recovered herself because she recovered whatever the enemy had destroyed in her life, because she was able to gather herself and she was able to win herself. She won herself the day she decided, I'll crew down. It doesn't matter how many physicians I've gone to. It doesn't matter how many times I've failed. I've looked for healing, but all has become in vain. But this time, I'll also rise up and do the same. I say, as I finish, rise up from where you are. Rise up from where you are. Rise up from your sick bed. Rise up. Do it again. Was it prayer? You have prayed and you have come to the end yourself and you feel that I cannot pray again. I come to encourage you. I come to challenge you. Rise up and pray. Is it fasting? You have fasted so many times and nothing has ever happened in your life and you feel you are down as if you cannot fast again. I come to encourage you. Rise up and continue to fast. This woman spent everything, but she was able to rise up and she recovered all that the enemy had done. You can also recover your children. You can recover your marriage. You can recover your health. You can recover your property. You can recover the gifts and whatever the enemy has destroyed. Don't allow the situation to destroy you. Rise up and confront that issue. God is well able to give you victory. You can rise up. I don't know, don't care how many times you're fallen. The Bible says a righteous man can fall 7 times, but he can still rise up again. And I'm confident of this. You can still rise up again and you can win this battle. You can win this battle. It is never over your life. As long you are breathing, as long you are alive, as long you are born again, as long you believe in God, it is never over with you. You can still make it and you can still recover. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Be with us tomorrow. We welcome you also in our main service. Karibu sana, wherever you are. Karibu, we welcome you also tomorrow. We apologize for those who didn't get us on Wednesday and Friday, but we are back and God bless you. Amen.